Hi, this is Bill Cosby. I'd like for you to pay close attention to this album because it's very important. We want to talk about amphetamines, cocaine, depressants, barbiturates, opiates, alcohol, tobacco, hallucinogens. We want you and your parents to give a listen.
First of all, we want to talk about the downers and the uppers. Do you think it's fun to have to take a pill or to sniff something or to snort something or to shoot something in your arm to make yourself feel, as a lot of people think, better?
No!
Now, one guy is going to describe how it feels for you to take a downer and how it feels for you to take an upper. Okay, now, let's talk about pills, all right? People take pills to get high, you see. Now, some pills are called downers. So, if we take a downer, it kind of makes us feel sleepy. And we think we feel good, like...
There, you're on a downer now. You've taken one, and now it's starting to react in your body, and now you feel like this. That's not much fun, is it? You thought you were gonna get high, but you're just very drowsy and sleepy and bumping into people. You don't want to bump into people, so why not take an upper? Oh yes, an upper will make you high.
It'll make you wake up and you'll think you're faster than you ever were. Now the upper's working. Now let's feel an upper. Oh my goodness, this isn't any fun either, is it? Now you're walking faster, you think, and you're talking faster, you think. But the only thing that's really happening is that you're thinking you're doing things faster, but you're not. And guess what? You won't be able to get to sleep. So let's go back to our natural state. A state which says no pills at all, and how do we enjoy ourselves? Oh, isn't that much better? Yeah. No uppers, no downers, just us. Us. The way we are. That's when we're fun. If we don't feel like staying up, we go to sleep. We don't feel like sleeping, we stay awake. But certainly without uppers and downers. Say no to pills. Can anybody name a drug, one drug for me? Yes, ma'am.
LSD.
LSD. Now, what do you know about LSD?
It makes you do things that you don't want to do.
Oh, things like what? Yes, ma'am.
Killing people.
Killing people? All right. I don't know, but yes, sir?
Makes you kill yourself, jump off the building.
Yes.
Commit suicide.
Sure. Yes, ma'am.
And make you steal things.
Make you steal things. And why do you think people really want to take LSD? Yes, ma'am.
People make them take them.
Who? Who would make them take it?
Bad people.
Bad people.
Strangers.
Strangers.
People that took it before.
People that took it before. And how would a person who has taken it before get somebody else to take it?
They sell it.
Sell it to them? How can I get you to take it if I've taken it before? See, they could try to trick you, couldn't they? They could say, this will really make you feel good, wouldn't they? Here's something for you to make you really feel good. What's the word for really feeling good that a lot of dope addicts use? Go ahead.
On your own trip.
On your own trip. Now, name another drug.
Proud Mary.
What is a Proud Mary? I don't know.
That's
what a...
That's marijuana.
Marijuana is called a Proud Mary? Is that right?
It's called pot. You can even have
And also pot. Called pot, huh? So what about marijuana? I mean, how do you use that?
You take a piece of paper and roll over that and make a cigarette out of it.
You make a cigarette out of it?
Yeah.
And then what do you do?
You smoke it.
You smoke it?
Yeah.
Do you just puff on it or what?
Yeah, just puff
it.
No.
You
light it.
You light it, yes.
And then some smoke goes into your lungs.
Just like you see people smoking cigarettes.
That gives you lung cancer.
Right. But by the same token, that's how you smoke your marijuana, or your Mary Jane, or your pipe, or your grass. You can smoke your rug if you want to. You can smoke a plate. You say some drug, right? Well, how about the people who tried to smoke bananas? Yeah, there were some people who want to get high. If you tell them anything that they smoke will get them high, they'll try it. People have tried to smoke bananas.
What if he doesn't have any?
He'll buy a banana or steal a banana, because that's what people do who love to get high. They will try to get high any way they can.
What do bananas do to you?
I don't know. I never smoked one because I never wanted to get high. What about if you're out in a schoolyard playing and somebody comes up to you? It doesn't have to be a grown-up. Suppose some kid who got into his mother's medicine cabinet and has her pills, or any kind of pills. They could look like aspirin tablets.
What if it looks like candy?
Okay, yeah. I'll ask you that question. What if it looks like candy?
That's what I would do.
What would you do?
I'd say, can I have them?
Yeah.
Then I'd throw them away.
You'd throw them away? But then they would be on the ground for maybe a little baby to come along and pick up and put it in his mouth. Well, see, what you want to do is you want to destroy them first. Or if you have good sense, you'll take them and then you'll give them to who?
The mother.
No, well, suppose you're in school.
The
who
teacher.
Would you give them? You give them to your teacher, right? Or if you're at home, you take them and you give them to...
Your mother.
Right.
Or your father.
And you say, somebody did what? Somebody
gave these.
Right. So what we're saying is, no matter who it is or what it is, if somebody offers you pills or something like that, you're going to say what?
No.
No, thank you. You don't want to take any candy or anything from anybody you don't know. And even then, you have to look at it very carefully. Suppose a friend of yours came up and it looked like candy, what would you do?
My mother said, don't take candy from strangers.
If you took some LSD and somebody tricked you,
yeah.
What would you do?
You have to go straight to your house if you can, or you have to find a grown-up. You have your name and address written someplace?
I have it written in my
head. I know mine.
I have mine written in my head.
You should have it in your pocket at all times.
She ran nowhere.
I got mine in my head.
No, but that isn't any good, because suppose you're crossing the street and some wild driver comes by and hits you and he knocks you out cold and you have it in your head. Now, how are we going
to
get your address out of your head?
They have to check your pockets and stuff.
Sure. Yes, ma'am.
One time, Lisa told me that on Halloween, this boy had trick-or-treating, and then he went over to his uncle's house, and he ate up all the candy, and then the boy went home and went to sleep. The people tried to wake him up, but he didn't wake up because he was dead.
Is that right? How do we get drugs?
You buy them.
You buy them.
From people.
From people. So what do we call a man or a boy who sells drugs? It begins with a P.
Pollution.
Yes, that's a form of pollution, but he's a pusher, and a pusher carries a bag of all kinds of drugs. Pusher will sell you any kind of drugs you want. Okay, now I'm going to play a song, and you'll hear this guy tell you that the pusher's coming, all right?
Here comes the dope pusher. He's got a bag of things that he will say will make you feel beautiful. Heroin, cocaine, he has some uppers and some downers, and marijuana, and all kinds of good things that will one day have you in pain and agony. But you can look at him right in the face, and you can sing this song to him. I don't need no bad drugs. I don't need no bad drugs. I don't need no bad drugs. Sing along with me. I don't need no bad drugs. I don't need no bad drugs. Now watch him walk away, because he can't sell you his bag of agony and pain. Goodbye, dope pusher. Goodbye with your bag of death and agony and pain. You'll have to find somebody not as smart.
So that's what we want to tell the dope pusher. When somebody comes to sell us some drugs.
I like that first part.
Here comes the dope pusher. He's coming to there.
So the dope pusher comes, what do you say to him?
I don't need no bad guns.
Let's just be quiet. 1 second, please. They put me in charge here, and you guys keep talking. Now, let's be quiet. 1 second, please, because I'm in charge. Now. Why are you?
I'm in charge.
I'm in charge. Now, I want to ask you a very tricky question here. May I have your attention, please? Will you stop fooling around with each other? Seem to be losing your attention here. All right, here we go. I can't talk to you if you're all going to talk and run your mouths and hit each other and tap each other and give each other five. And you keep complaining that he's pinching. He's not pinching you anymore. And before he was, but now, see, you just hit him. You did. See, you just did it again. You just went to fool around with him again. I have one more question to ask before I send you home, because I'm totally disgusted with you. It's just embarrassing what you've done here today, and I thought you were going to be nice people, but you've run over my class, and I'm just totally insulted by this whole thing. So there. Why are you laughing at that? That's a sad story.
Maybe it might be true, Laura.
No. All right, seriously now. How about drugs that people shoot into their bodies? Anybody know?
The kind of thing.
With a needle.
Oh, they put up the sleeve.
Anybody know the name of that drug? Begins with an H. Heroin.
Yeah.
Heroin.
Heroin.
Yeah, and they shoot that into the body.
What did that do?
Well, it goes into the body and it just slows everything down.
You're bloodstained and you'll die.
Well, if you take too much of it. But all of these bad drugs can kill you. But you see, all bad drugs are sold through the underground.
What do you mean?
I mean, people who have no authority to sell them whatsoever. In other words, the law says you can't do that. It's against the law. So they say, well, even though it's against the law, we're going to sell it anyway. So chances are, when you take bad drugs, the people who mix this dope up can give you too much.
Why do they mix dope up?
They mix dope up and they sell it just so they can make money. For no other reason. They're not interested in your feeling good or your feeling high.
What?
They just want to make money. And as long as you are an addict, see, you shoot this stuff into your arm and into your body, and pretty soon the veins that you shoot them in can't take it that much, because you may have to shoot that needle into yourself 4 or 5 times a day. And it's very, very expensive. Sometimes it may cost you as much as $200 a day. So they'll steal your television set and sell it so that they can make money to shoot that dope into their arms. You can see pictures of people who shoot heroin and other drugs into the body. Pretty soon, all those needle marks are all over their arms and all over their legs. They really look like they had a terrible, terrible case of chicken pox. And you know those scars that run down the arms or down the legs? We call them tracks. And they're called tracks because they only lead straight to the grave. A lot of young kids really are in trouble because you can take too much or somebody can give you something, and what will happen?
You'll die.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And that's terrible. Terrible.
Do you have another song?
Yes, we have another song. I found a way out. Took a few reds. Took a handful of reds. Took a fistful of reds. Took a bucket full of reds. And I feel good. Good, I say. Here's another song now. You have to listen carefully to this one. Marijuana never did anything to me. I've always enjoyed it. Have a good smoke, sit back and watch TV. Colors jump right out at your face. And then I just go to sleep. Never touch the hard stuff. It's bad for you. But I do find that at certain times during the day, the times get hard. I don't like to drink, get an ulcer myself, but I do like smoking. Smoking's enjoyable. I sit back and hope the cops don't catch me or anything like that. I mean, but that's just a small problem. I mean, they don't understand it, so it's against the law, but I enjoy good smoke. Roll them up myself. Sometimes I've gotten sacks and seeds are pretty bad. It's hard to strain it, but I enjoy being high. Matter of fact, last week I was smoking and it was really some excellent, excellent stuff. Come over from Mexico by way of Puerto Rico underneath the Cuban grapevine. And I smoked one and sitting up there and while I was enjoying myself, I thought it was a dream that somebody was taking my TV set away. So I just sat there and giggled. And when I woke up, it was gone. People make mistakes just about every day of their lives. And most of them have an excuse. They say, I didn't know. I didn't understand. And we forgive. We forgive them because they didn't know, and we say, that's all right, just make sure that you don't do it again, and we hope that they won't. But then, there are some people who make the same mistake over and over and over again. I'm telling you, that bad drugs will cause great sorrow in your family, will cause you to shun the ones you love, and will cause the ones who love you to spend nights crying for you, spend nights searching for you, spend nights praying for you, and all they can ever say is, I hope one day the habit will go away and he'll come back strong and as beautiful as we had always hoped he would be. Why start? We want you to listen to the next song.
I think
this next song, this is about a guy who felt that he could handle it. He could just take care of everything. I know I can take drugs anytime I want, and I can stop it anytime I want. Everybody's got a feeling about themselves like, well, sure, I know it happened to them, but it certainly couldn't happen to me. So what if I smoke a little pot? Sure, I may take a pill or two, but that doesn't make any difference. I know how to handle it. I know how to handle it, man. I think I'm going to experiment next week, too. I'm going to sniff a little coke, and I may even shoot some heroin. I know I can handle it. Yeah, I know I can handle it. Yeah, I know. I saw the guy down the street with all them needle marks on his arms and legs. And I heard about it costing $9,000 a year to keep his habit going. But I know I can handle that. I mean, I'm not going to get strung out. What's strung out? Oh, that's when you really got a bad, bad habit, you know. Like you're unfortunate, you're weak in the mind. But I know, man, I can handle that. I mean, any smart person can handle... What? Smart person. A smart person is somebody who can handle it. I'm smart. What do you mean if I'm smart? What am I doing smoking and taking pills? I'm smart because... Well, ain't nothing happened to me yet. What do you mean, but I'm getting ready to get into some heavy stuff? Oh, man, don't tell me that. I know better. I'm just going to see. What do you mean that's what happened to Freddie? You mean he was just going to see, and now he can't see? At all? Well, I know Freddy died, but see, he wasn't smart. I know I can handle that. I know I can handle that, 'cause I'm smart. Who's smarter than me? Well, maybe somebody who never even wanted to see if they can handle it. Now, what do you think of a guy who thinks that he can handle bad drugs? What do you think of a guy who says, I know I can handle that?
He's crazy.
All right. Now, we have a song. Captain Junkie, look on your rug. Is it a roach? Is it a dead rat? No! It's Captain Junkie. coming into your living room, stealing your TV set, taking anything you can possibly get. Captain Junkie! We find Captain Junkie nodding out in the park, falling off of his seat onto his face. And we move in closely and hear Captain Junkie speak. Oh, wow. Am I stoned? I feel so good. Coming into your hearts, America. A leading citizen. Falling off of the park benches. Bumping into poles. Dropping glasses in the middle of company. Making conversation like, yeah, well, helping America build itself to a bigger and better place. We find Captain Junkie walking into a parked car. Oh, no, man. Captain Junkie, a man to be looked up to. Captain Junkie is taking a shower. We find him looking at his body. Oh. These marks are just too much for me. Little kids look at Captain Junkie and say, Mommy, what's the matter with that man? Why is he always bumping into things and falling down? Get away, son. You don't want to be like him. That's Captain Junkie. Captain Junkie, one of America's leading citizens. Falling into your living room, dropping your glasses, stealing your TV set, trying to sell some dope to your children. One of America's leading citizens. This was sponsored by People to Look Up To.
Ooh, Captain Junkie.
Don't you like Captain Junkie? He's a wonderful person, isn't he?
No!
Why isn't Captain Junkie a good
person? He's still here!
Captain Junkie,
take him out of
the
stinky.
Yeah.
And he
has holes all over.
He's junkie and stuff.
Boom, take him out of the picture.
And Captain Junkie wants to sell you some bad drugs.
No.
Don't you want to buy some bad drugs?
Yeah.
Okay, this is a song. It's a very simple song.
Oh.
This song is called Dope. It's for the dopeys.
Yeah.
Okay,
it's
now here we go. We want to clap. Pap.
Pap. Pap.
Dope is for the dopeys. 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 Okay, that's good. Now the other song is La La Lee Lee Lee.
La La Lee Lee Lee.
La 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 la
la la la la la
la la la
la la la la.
Now whenever I finish singing it, you will say la 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 la.
And then when you finish again with that,
yeah, la 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 la. Right. Now I want you to really sing it loud and clear. Yeah, but that's the cool part about it. For instance, now, I'll say, I don't take no drugs.
La, 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 la.
I don't need no drugs.
La, 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 la.
If somebody tries.
La, 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 la.
To sell them to me.
La, 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 la.
I will say to them.
La, 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 la.
No, get it together, Dodo. Okay, here we go. Now, let's all sing it loud and clear, and you can clap to the music if you like. Okay, here we go. I don't need no drugs.
La, 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 la.
I don't need no drugs.
La, 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 la.
If somebody tries.
La, 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 la.
To sell them to me.
La, 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 la.
All I say to them.
La, la, li, li, li.
Is this. Dope is for the dopey. 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 D
dope is for the dopey. Dope is for the dopey. Dope is for the dopey. Dope is for the dopey.
This is Bill Cosby. There's a need to get more education and information to fully understand all drugs. I hope you enjoyed the album, and I hope your parents did too.
I'm Bill Cosby, and the kids in Los Angeles have a slogan, Speed Kills. And they're not referring to safe driving habits. They're talking about a group of drugs, including ups, meth, pep pills, dex, even bennies. Dangerous drugs. Sometimes fatal to the users. And you should know about the up drugs. You may even be taking some now and not be aware of their danger. Write for this free booklet, The Up and Down Drug. Don't guess about drugs when you can have the facts.